Welcome back to Dark Chronicle, and we're at the peak of Mount Gundor. And this machine behind us is the Fire Squall. And that's been shooting down burning embers onto Heim Rada below, which means that we can't make any wooden or straw buildings anymore. But we still need to build the future enough so we can go into the future and find some way to destroy that thing, so that then we can better create the past. Because we need to get rid of all of these burning embers that you can see falling now. But before any of that, since it is around midnight in the game time, if we head over here, there are some hot springs we can go to. And if you come down to the hot springs around midnight, then we can take some pictures. The first picture being the hot spring itself, and also this ghost here that you just saw, the hot spring spirit. So that's going to be here between midnight and 4 a.m, just like the other two ghosts, the one in Palm Brink and the one at Venetio Coast. So without further ado, time for us to go into the Carpentarian and enjoy for the second to last time the PS2 loading times of the Geostones. It's like a fine wine, it's succulent. There we go, and we can make the Iron Chimney too, with Stair Block, Generator, Great Crane, Power Arm and Hardened Mud Pile. But that's it, they're the only new buildings that we can currently make. That's because this time we're going to actually use buildings that we've used in the past, for once. There aren't many new buildings, and there's Borneo who needs to live here. So let's check what we gotta do. So we need a house 3 blocks high, Borneo needs to live here, we need some pots planted, stuff like that, we need a windmill put down, and right here, right at the end, is Pasno's Completed. That's the machine that's going to win the future war for the rebellion. So we can't make these straw buildings anymore, they're out of the picture, we also can't make the wooden house anymore. What we can make is either brick or iron. I personally prefer brick, because brick looks nicer. If anyone's going to live here for 100 years, they may as well do it in brick buildings. So let's give everyone some lamps and the like. Let's make a well for everyone to get water. Let's make some laundry for everyone. Let's see, and then down here is where all those blocks are going to come in handy that we've been getting so far. So these blocks can be used to make things higher up in the air. Let's also make 4 great cranes. 4 power arms, we made the windmill, we're going to make the generator, and down here there's some hardened wood piles. I forgot how many of these you have to make, let's make 16 for now. Because first off, with the hardened wood piles we're going to stop these geysers, when they're going to interfere with us. Let's just go and cover up all of these. Now it's also worth noting that if you are planning to cover all these up, which I do just because it kind of helps with the future and all that jazz, you should make sure to first get off and take a picture of one of them. Because once you've put all of these down, there's no going back from that, you can't remove them, these geysers are out permanently. So you do need to make sure you take a picture of that one. Right, let's put you down there. Is there any more geysers still up? There's one there. Now, did we get them all? Nope, there's one more here. That looks like we've got every geyser here. Okay, so we didn't need to use all of those after all. So another thing we're going to be using now then is choosing which types of bricks to use. If you're going to be using iron houses, then you need bigger, like wider ones because they're square, and brick houses are longer. So we're going to get these longer ones. So let's make about 30 of those. I did get loads and loads of stones, so it's not really an issue if we have to make loads of stuff. Let's make block twos. Let's make some bridge blocks. Let's make 10 of those. Some stairs. Let's make 15 of those. And let's make a few normal blocks just to help out. And now it's time for us to get started. So first things first, you've got to choose where you're starting here. You don't need the entire place, which is kind of a shame, because it is a nice huge area, it would be nice to use it all. I personally prefer to choose the opening area here that's next to the time gate. That makes the most sense to me. Let's put it back a little bit so we can build. Let's put the magnet on. And gonna have to zoom in to make sure we get all these buildings lined up with each other. There you go, that looks lined up. We're gonna put those like that. And then we'll get some bridge blocks on this side. We'll turn them around. I'll just start to put them down, so we have a nice little bridge that leads out. There we go. And then turn them around here. There you go, that's lined up perfectly. And then we'll start with some of the other blocks we've been making a lot of. These ones here. So we'll start off with that one, lined up perfectly. And then from here, because we can, we may as well make it look nicer with some bridge blocks. So I'll put these here just to make it look a little bit nicer. Is that lined up well? Yeah, that's lined up perfectly. Let's turn this one around and then put it down. That's lined up perfectly as well. Turn this around twice. I believe that's lined up, isn't it? Yep, it is. Good. Now we'll turn this one around and line up again. So you have a nice little bridge here. Just makes it look a little bit nicer. And that is what Georama's all about, after all. Right, so there's a nice little bit of bridge. So now, let's go and build these bridge blocks. So I have, well not bridge blocks, rather the long ones. So we're going to have that go in there. And then this one, we're going to have half and half here. It like that, and then like that, and then put some other ones behind it. And then on this side we'll do the same, so we'll start off with going backwards, line it up for it. And yes, most of the building in this place is putting down the foundations. And then once again, was it last time did we use a full thing? Yeah, we did. May as well use a full thing again then this time. That looks about right to me. Let's put that down. And then put another two here behind them. And then in the middle there, we're going to go use some more bridge blocks. I'm going to have to make two more of those though, because I miscounted. But that's fine. Everything's fine with Georama, pretty much. You just, if it doesn't look right, just change it. It's fine. Don't worry about it. Let's make two more bridge blocks. And let's place those down. Just line it up nicely. I think that's in line. Yep, that's in line. Good. Maybe a little bit off, it looks like. But it looks close enough. And then behind here, we'll continue with the big blocks. So we use those, and then I'll make them go back again over here. And this time, I'll have these two going up. Now then, the choice here is where to go and put down the stairs. Let's start with putting some stairs down. There we go, that's the first set of stairs. Then the second set's going to be here. Next up, we're going to be looking to put down some stairs over here, so let's use the big block for the time being. I'll have this one go back here. So I'll have this one line up for us. That'll do. Put another one on top, and then put one more there. And I'll put another one here that attaches to it. So that'll be for foundations for one of the two houses, and we'll do the same over this side. So I'll put three there. I need one more, I forgot to make more, that's fine. I'll just make some more now. Again, I got loads and loads of those stones, so we're not going to run out. So we can do whatever we want with them. There we go. And this one here, we can line that one up perfectly. And then at the back here, we're going to go and place some more of those big blocks. That's higher than everything else, which is the goal here, because that one is supposed to be higher. And we'll place down the normal blocks over here, because this is going to be another way inside. There we go, and then one on the other side. Time to put down more stairs. So these stairs are going to go downstairs as well. Same with this side. So that's all the stairs sorted so far. Next up is over here. So these stairs are going to go up to where the houses are. I think we're running out of stairs, so we'll make a few more just in case. And it looks like we put that stair block too close, so we'll just move that one quickly. But remember, there's no penalty for messing up with Georama. You're allowed to put down the pieces as many times as you want. Now we'll put the final two up here. There we go. But there is still one more building you want to put down. We're going to use the bigger blocks for that one. So this building is going to be a little bit important, so we'll just give it its own little space here. First row, have we got any more bridge blocks? I think we should make some. Blocks down here. Just line that up nicely. And I'll put a second one here. This is going to be a little bit different than the last one, so it's fine. We're just going to go with it. Just line this up with where it looks like it goes on the floor. Blocks. Because one very important person is going to live here, and we want to make this place look nice and fancy for them. Let's make even more. Oh, no, we can't anymore, never mind. Let's not make it look that fancy, then, eh? Let's just have a nice square. After all, they've been a jerk to us throughout the entire game, so why do we have to make the place look nice for them? So you may have guessed already who we're putting here. And if you haven't, then you're going to see it soon. So it's time for us to actually go and place down the buildings already. Because like I said before, the foundations take the longest. And then we got the buildings. So where are my four brick houses? There they are. So to start off with, we're going to put the brick houses up here. There we go, that's one of them. Here's another for the foreman in the middle. There's a third one. And finally over here, there's going to be one very special important house. Looks to be lined up quite nicely, we'll put that there. Now time to put down the chimneys and everyone. So then, let's go here. So chimney on this side. I like to set up all the houses the same. So when it turns around, I'm pretty sure that means chimney is on this side as well, isn't it? Wait, this is going to be annoying. So it's facing that way, the chimney on the left side. Facing that way, the chimney on the left side. I'm pretty sure this is it. I could be wrong. Now let's place down the power arms. Actually no, the great cranes first, I think they're bigger. Let's put those there. So that everyone can do some lifting. And then the power arms. Put those down on everything. Over here as well, because he keeps demanding that we do work so he can do work. And now let's put the lion lamps on everyone, so everyone has some light. Let's put on the front. There we go. I still don't know of a way to declip without accidentally removing the thing that we just put down from the houses, so I'll just keep going to the venue each time. It's not going to take much longer anyway. Doors for everyone. So we did gain the iron chimney and stuff like that, but we're not going to have to use any of that, so it's fine. Because that would be if we were making like iron houses, but I prefer brick houses. I'm going to put this well in the centre so everyone can get a drink. Over here, near this house. Let's make sure that it's kind of lined up nicely with the thing on the floor. There we go. I suppose we'll back it up a little bit like that. Yeah, that'll be fine. Put down the generator. I'll put it over here so it doesn't keep people awake. That's going to power everything. So we could put some laundry onto houses as well, but that's going to burn. Because that's wooden. Well, it's counted as like wooden or straw in that category. Also the well is as well, so we'll have to remove that. But that's where I want to put it anyway. So I'll have to make another well for later after it burns. But people deserve, you know, the fresh drink while they're still living here, even if it's going to burn down. Then again, it needs sturdy rocks and we can't get them, so we'll just clean this up. So we don't waste it. There we go. Because yeah, that would burn down, because for some reason even though it's made out of bricks, it would still count as a wooden building. I don't don't know why. Let's make sure we get everything. So that's everything put down. Now we just need to make us some pots. This is needed for one of the things you have to do. We need to move 10 of those. Let's put down all 10 pots. Put one near each house, I suppose. And one for you as well. Fine, you can have one. Even though you're never grateful for anything I ever do. That guy should be lucky that he's even getting a house. So yeah, if you're still not aware who that is, because you haven't picked up on Max's frustration against the person, we'll put him in a house soon, so it's no problem. There we go, that's all those put down. So we're now 10%, but we do need to put some people to live here. So without further ado, let's go put some people down. Now Borneo over here. Being a change in the future. Borneo's the foreman, so he can move in. So this is the end of the road for him. He's no longer joining us. Play the mate. And over here, we're going to have Eric living here near the windmill. There we go. And on the far side, we're going to have Cedric living there. Because this is his stop as well, this is where he goes off for good. There you go, Cedric. And finally, without further ado, let's go and put the final person to live there, who won't be grateful in the slightest that we've done it. Go on then. Go live here, Dad. Stop being such a jerk to Max, Dad. God, I'm just trying to save the world. And that's 80% complete. So what we need to actually 100% the place is, you may have noticed we've got all this other stuff done. The only two things we haven't done is created pals notes that we need to do the boss fight for. And the operations room, and what we need for that is the fire scroll destroyed. The 100 culture points, we can get that very easily. But to do that, we're going to have to put down things like the laundry and stuff, and the laundry will burn, so we can't do that. So we'll have to come back and do that one later. As soon as we destroy the fire scroll, then we'll be able to put down wooden buildings and stuff. So this is how it looks at the moment. It looks pretty nice, but like I said, it's kind of my big problem with this diorama, is that there's all this room we haven't used. Like, we've used like a quarter of it. It's actually more than I remembered using. I thought it was like 1/10 or something. So we are using quite a bit, and that's when I like overbuilt. Like, I did all this building that wasn't really needed and stuff to like extend it. And that's really the problem with this area, is that it's really expensive to build the stuff if you did want to go all over the place with it, and there's really no need to. Kind of annoying. Anyway, I forgot to show you what it looked like before we actually changed the future at all, so I'll splice that in afterwards, but for now, let's go to the future, and let's go and see what we've done for the place to up to 80% in so far. And yes, we are taking Cedric with us to the future, even though he's supposed to stay here for the next 100 years to recreate the future. Don't ask how that's going to work, it just does. That's time travel for you, I guess.
So this is the Great Workshop!
Yes, Gundorada Workshop. The name is taken from Mount Gundor and the village below it, Heim Rada. Paznos, the mobile stronghold of our rebel army, was once built here.
Wow, that's something.
Let's go to the second floor.
Yeah, okay.
Yep, so this is Gundorada Workshop in the future. As you can see, it looks like there's a giant gap there, that something should be there between those four work arms. Just took a picture of one of them there, and that's because that's where Paznos is going to be. But to get that made, what we need is the operations room restored, and to do that we just need to destroy the fire squall in the future. And we also need to beat the boss fight, because those are the two conditions to recreate Paznos. So basically, Paul, we've done everything we needed to do. So this is a huge area. So let's just go and use the teleporter that's here. I almost forgot it was there then. So there's loads of different shops here. There's a weapon shop, there's a tool shop, there's stuff like that. How you doing, mate? Yup. Later, mate. Let's go to the second floor.
Maximilian, nice to meet you.
The origin point of this workshop was erased. We're in the middle of trying to bring it back.
Ah, so that's what happened, is it? Everything changed so suddenly, I had no idea what was going on. So do you think you'll be able to restore the workshop?
Well, there's a problem. They're trying to put a stop to our building by raining embers down on Heim Rada.
Embers? That's probably the fire squall.
The fire squall?
Yes, in the beginning they tried to destroy the workshop directly using that device.
The workshop itself?
The fire squall is a terrifying device that takes energy from the volcano and turns it into a boiling hot rain that burns up man-made things. We were able to protect the workshop by destroying the device in the volcano's crater.
I guess their scheme failed, so they decided to set up the fire squall in the past and prevent the workshop from ever existing.
Yeah, I guess that's what happened.
So we have to take out the fire squall in the past as well, right?
That's right. I think the device is probably near the crater at the top of the volcano. Use this.
Yeah, I just carry a time bomb around me at all times.
Use it to blow up the fire squall. Make sure they don't find it before it goes off.
Okay, I got you. Thanks, Garrick.
See you. Good luck.
So as he just said then, also there's a treasure chest here, let's go grab it. So as he did just say, as well as... Oh, there's another treasure chest here, let's grab it. So third time's a charm, so as he just said, the goal of the moment then is to go back and use this time bomb he just gave us to destroy the fire squall in our time. But at the same time, there's a problem, because it is a time bomb after all, so we need to make sure that they don't find it before it goes off. But there's only one way we're going to do that when it's flying around on a huge airship, and that's to preoccupy it by fighting it. So as I mentioned before, we do need to eventually find a way to destroy this airship, and this sounds like a good a time as any. So if he does start to interfere with us with blowing up the fire squall, we're going to have to make sure he doesn't find the time bomb by attacking the airship directly so that he can't even look down for it. So that's going to be what we're doing in the next part. We're going to take that down as the boss fight, and then we'll be heading inside the volcano after that to find our way straight to the center and find out what's going on down there. So when we come back, that's what we'll be doing. So I'll see you next time, so be lovely to each other, and farewell.